So I am doing my first BoxyCharm and Sephora video that I've done in a very long time, it feels like. So yeah, seems like it's been a long time. So I'm like, okay, what do I do? This is not the Sephora video. So this video is the BoxyCharm of March. Let's get into it. All right, March BoxyCharm. This theme is supposed to be creepy cute, but to be completely honest, I did not feel that that was like very much the theme, but let's just get into it. The first thing we have on here is the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer. This is like the classic Smashbox primer. This retails for $16. I wonder if that is for this size, because I'm pretty sure that the full thing is not $16. And you know, I gotta say, BoxyCharm, it used to be that we did not get samples. Kinda looks like a sample to me. But hey, who am I to say? I'm just a girl with a video camera. Okay, yeah, the normal size is $36, but this size, you can buy this size on Macy's for $16. So this is an oil-free primer. It says it's the first product ever created at Smashbox. So yeah, it's like the tip, the like classic iconic Smashbox product. It instantly blurs fine lines and pores, leaving skin with a velvety smooth even finish. This classic Smashbox primer is the best way to start your makeup every day. I've never used this primer before. It is definitely like a silicone kind of feel and all of that. It definitely has silicone in it. Let's just go with that. Cause I did use this. I didn't use this in this video because I used a different primer that I got, but this is very interesting. I would recommend really giving it the old shake a shake, because when it first came out, it was more like the Smashbox primer water. And it was kind of weird looking, like it wasn't discolored, obviously, because there's no color, but it definitely needed to be shaken. And if you can kind of see, it's still kind of like separating in the tube a little bit. So it's definitely something that you have to like shake hardcore, and it does shake, even though you would think that it would be too thick, but it does move. You just really have to do it so much that I like literally can't talk while I do it. So this, I did try it. I felt like it was okay. Like, honestly, I have yet to meet a primer that I'm like, oh my god, this totally helps the longevity of my makeup. It makes my makeup look smoother. All of that. Yet to meet one. I don't know what. My skin is apparently just never ever happy. So I don't know. This was just kind of a wah for me, like a middle of the road kind of thing, but you know, it's nice, so it is what it is. The next thing we have on the list here is something I did really like from the box. This is the Deluxe Femme Brush by Crown Brush, also listed as the, god, I'm an old woman, I'm like, the SS023 Deluxe Fan Brush. And it even has it on the handle here. It is the Jumbo Kabuki Fan. This thing is sweet. I really like this. It's super soft. It's big. I do like that it's big, but I have such a fucked up brush like storage situation right now that it's getting kind of warped in my little storage, which is really fucked. But it's big. It's like perfect for highlight. I did use this in my video with this. It says it features a large fan brush head, perfect for the soft application of powder products. The brush is also great for lightly dusting shimmer products onto skin. I've also seen a lot of girls on Instagram using this to contour. I have not done that yet, but I should, and I should have done that in the video instead of using it for a separate highlight. But that's okay. I really like this. I would definitely expect this to be $18.99 is the price they have listed here. I would definitely expect this to be that price. For some reason, big fan brushes like this are like kind of expensive, and like, I guess because they're big, but like, I would expect a fan brush, which doesn't seem to like have like a ton of substance to it, to like not really be that expensive, but I don't make brushes, so. I did wash it, actually, and it came out totally fine. So it didn't, like, lose a bunch of hair or anything like that. It's hella soft. It is, like, Oh, I really like it. It makes me want to buy more crown brushes, to be honest. I don't own any crown brushes that haven't been given to me. Like, I think this is one. Nope, that's Royal and Lang Nickel. So I don't have any crown brushes for sure, which is sad. But from what I understand, they're like a little bit pricey, and that makes sense because $18.99 seems a little bit pricey to me. I don't know. It's not like crazy pricey, but it seems a little pricey. My eye is like watering, like it is over. It's over it. Whenever I put makeup on, the corners of my eyes are just like, yo, fuck this, I'm out. Whatevs. The next thing is the thing that I used the most in my video of this look. It is the Urban Rustic Palette by Naked Cosmetics. How you would know that it would be called that? I have no fucking idea, because there is no shade names, nothing. It just says Naked Cosmetics. Not my favorite thing. It says that this retails for $39.99. I would never fucking pay that for this trio. Just because the packaging seems cheap. It's not that they're bad shadows. The packaging seems cheap. You're not even gonna give me shade names for $39.99. Like, come on now. That's a joke. But, and I also don't like that. I can't go any farther than that. Super annoying, but whatever. Here we go. So you get these three colors. God, what is the best way to show you this without blinding you? You get these three colors. You get a red, like a deep red, a deep orange, and then a nice green. And I do like the colors. They are super pigmented. I will swatch them for you. They're very soft. You know, I mean, they're softish. They're not like crazy. The red is the least soft for sure. But yeah, this is what I have predominantly on my eyes right now. Let me just swatch them here for you. I'm not going to drag crazy hard. I'm just going to kind of go across. And there you go. As you can see, they're pretty pigmented. The red is probably the least. The one that I like the most and that I did not think I would like the most, because I saw it and I was like, the fuck am I gonna do with that? I do have a ColourPop Super Shock shadow that I feel is fairly similar to that green. I was like, oh, I'm not gonna use the green. What am I gonna use the green in this two little trio? Like, you, the red and the orange seem like they can definitely go together. I was like, how am I gonna do the green? So I did the red on my lid, and then I literally was like at the pan of the orange, and I was like, what if I do the green on the inner corner instead of the orange? And I'm actually really glad that I did it. I'm pretty into it. I'm pretty into the eyes especially. I feel like maybe the lips was like a misstep, but I'm super feeling the eyes, so that's totally fine. I'm actually fairly happy with that little trio. Like I said, I had a quad, and I'm not gonna be able to, a Studio 1400. Wow, I'm so fucking smart. Studio 1400 quad of Super Shock Shadows that I got from ColourPop seem incredibly similar to these three, and let me just grab them. Okay, so it's a quad, so it comes with four. It came with this one, which is Donna. That obviously is not what we're looking at here, but what I am talking about, and looking at them in front of me, they are not, the green does not look like it's gonna be an exact dupe. This is the green I'm talking about, and in my mind, it looked a lot more similar to this green, but in the pan, it doesn't, so let's go and see what it looks like on my hand here. Obviously these are way more pigmented than these little Naked Cosmetics shadows. But yeah, so that is the green, and here is the green I was thinking of. They're obviously very different. I see that now. That's okay though, but I do think the orange and the red are very similar. All right, so then we've got the orange that I'm thinking of here from this quad is White Rabbit. That is, good lord, that is what it looks like. And you can see in the pan, they look very similar. I think I'm gonna be right about this one. And here is the Urban Naked one. And they are almost identical. Urban Naked might be like a fucking hair darker, but just very, very close. I think that on the eye, I don't know why I emphasized eye so much just now. I think on the eye, you probably would not be able to tell the difference at all between those two. Finally, for the red, we've got static here. I'm going to try and open this without having to wipe my hand off. The static, this might end up being just a touch darker than the red, but I don't know, that's looking pretty close. That's the red of the ColourPop. Let me just get the other one on my pinky here. Oh yeah, I'm thinking that these are pretty dang close. Yep, pretty close. I would say that those, I would say the ColourPop may be a hair darker, but not by much. And on the eye, you probably would not be able to tell. I don't think that those, that color palette is creepy cute in any way, shape, or form. Like, I expected to get maybe like some pastels, like some, you know, like the little card is. Okay, like, I don't want to shit on BoxyCharm, but like, I feel like this video is a little bit shitting on BoxyCharm. Like, the card is totally adorable, like blue, pink, pastel, goth kind of shit, like the Kat Von D palette that came out and all of that. And this is not screaming pastel goth to me, like, or creepy cute. I mean, like, come on, that's like fall. Like, and it is a little strange to me that we're coming into spring, and you know, ColourPop usually follows the trends. So it is strange to me that we get a trend-looking card and a fall off-trend-looking trio. So I don't know about that. The trio is decent quality. The red, when you swatch it, is not like buttery or like super smooth or anything, but on the eye it applied fine. I think it looks nice. I actually, the green is probably my favorite, and then the orange and then the red. I use the orange on the center of my lips here. I think the trio's okay. The colors are inspirational to me. If you're like a person who follows the seasons or the trends by that, that's not really gonna do it for you. This whole box isn't really gonna do it for you. Let's move on. The last two things we have are from the same brand, and they kind of, I think, I'm fairly certain that they match, like are supposed to be together. I saw on FabFitFun that someone got a trio of this company. The company is called Real Her. They got a trio where it's the liner, the liquid lipstick, which I have, and then a gloss. And I don't really care about like gloss, so I'm totally fine with that. I am super into matching liner and lip color whenever ColourPop comes out with stuff that matches now. Like, if I'm gonna buy that new color, I pretty much always buy the liner now. These are pretty cool because, and I don't, it's crazy because they don't address this on the card. I would not have known this if I had not watched the FabFitFun unboxing. I'm pretty sure I watched the ThriftThick one. These are from a company called Real Her. I believe, if I am remembering correctly, that they are a company that contributes money, part of their proceeds, to domestic violence. I'm super into that. That makes me really like these more. So the lip gloss itself has another one of these, but the lip liner says I am unique. The liquid lipstick says I am fearless, and I can't remember what the other one says. Maybe like I am strong, something along those lines. The liner is in the color, I'm not really sure if it's expert advice or if the color is expert advice or if the liner itself is called the Real Her Expert Advice Lip Liner. I don't know. It might just be like, I am unique. I'm not sure if it's I am unique, but then this lipstick, the liquid lipstick that says I am fearless, has a different name. This color is Lady Love. I know that other colors went out. I saw them on a BoxyCharm cell swap group I am a part of and newly a part of. But these are the colors I got, and they're very pretty. Let me just read you quickly. The liquid lipstick retails for $15, which is up there. But if the proceeds really do go to something, I factor that into the cost and like understand that, you know. It says the lightweight formula glides onto lips, leaving super intense color with a bold ultra matte finish. It's long wearing and completely kiss proof. This balm formulation helps to combat dryness and nourish your lips during wear. I did put this on first before I put this lip on, and it's a great color, and the opacity is totally there. Super smooth. Same with this. This lip liner is awesome. It's very buttery. I put it on the center of my lips to do kind of like an ombre lip, and this lip liner alone totally gave me that effect. I was able to like smooth it out with my lips alone, so it's very buttery and smooth. I just ended up not thinking it was the right thing for this look. For the lip liner itself, it says it's a creamy lip liner that glides across lips to define your pout. So let me swatch these for you quickly. I cannot actually tell you about like wear time or anything like that because I haven't worn them out or anything or worn them for extended periods of time, but I can give you pretty swatches. So let me just go across this just one time and just widen it out here. I think these are really pretty colors. I'm super into this color. And right here, I'll just... So that lip liner is very like creamy and super not hard. I cannot stand a lip liner that is hard, like my God. So that is those colors. And as you can see, like I'm fairly certain that these are supposed to go together, not only because I saw the trio little thing on FabFitFun, but also because they look exactly the same fucking color. I'm super into that. I'm super into this as a whole. Let me smell it. Very light scent. It's not really sweet, maybe mint, but not a lot. I actually really like the packaging too. It's this square packaging. It's got like Real Her there and the little transparent. It's kind of hard to catch that. It's got Real Her on the top. It's got I Am Fearless. It's got the bottom. I really like this. I really, really like this. This is by far my favorite thing of this box. For all that is the box. So let me just total it up for you here quickly. As you know, I'm sure BoxyCharm is $21 a month. That includes shipping and all of that. So it's just one flat fee. $21 a month. I actually really like BoxyCharm. This month is not great for me. Like, let me just go and say that for be real with that. I don't think this month really... It's not that they're bad products. The only thing that I really like when really feeling is a Smashbox primer. But I kind of do evaluate it on like the theme, because there's a theme for a reason. Otherwise, don't have a theme. And, you know, it is coming into spring. This is not very fucking springy. But, you know, I do really like ColourPop. I like them too. I do really like BoxyCharm. I've been with BoxyCharm for 2 years or more now. Like, that's kind of crazy. I always remember that October was my first box, and I've definitely been with them for 2 Octobers and then up until now. So that's what, November, December, January, February, March. That's almost 2.5 years. The price value that you get is $102.48. I think that's great value for a $21 box. And you know, overall, I will use like 4 out of 5 of the things. And the fifth thing is sample size. I will say that they typically, their thing is that they don't give sample sizes, but I'ma just like let that one go. Overall, this box is very decent to me, even though when I saw that the theme was creepy cute, I was really excited because I think I'm creepy cute, or at least creepy. And I was like, when I saw what was coming, I was like, the fuck? Like, that's not... It's not creepy, it's just cute. It's just philanthropic. That is the gist of all of my BoxyCharm thoughts for the month of March. Let me know down below what your favorite makeup brand is, or makeup or skincare, cosmetics, what have you, beauty brand that gives back. Your favorite philanthropic give back brand, because I'm super into that. And it would be kind of cool to start like a tag, right? Like a philanthropic tag. That would be kind of cool. Like the video if you liked it, if you found it helpful, or anything, if you like ColourPop dupes. it really helps me out, and I love to see that you guys like the stuff that I'm putting out. And subscribe if you want to see videos similar to this. I will be obviously doing the Sephora March box bag, and the I will have this look coming out soon, so subscribe if you want to be notified of those things. And I put out videos whenever I feel it, which is usually Mondays at noon. I'm really trying to get back on track, I promise. Usually Mondays at noon, PST represent. I will see you guys again next time. Bye!